Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's now discuss how the structure of biological drugs affects their PK to be different from small molecule oral drugs. By the end of this video, students will be able to contrast ADME and PK properties of small molecule drugs against biologic drugs and explain how these differences affect drug administration. In these videos, we emphasize small molecule oral drugs. Let's talk briefly about the properties that generally define small molecules and contrast them with biologics. We have two columns. The left is for small molecule drugs. Small molecule oral drugs are typically synthetic, wholly made in a lab. They are small because they have a relatively low molecular weight, generally less than 750 daltons or grams per mole, and often quite a bit lower. They often have a high membrane permeability. In contrast, biologics are typically proteins or antibodies prepared by biological systems, living systems. The molecular weight of these compounds is much higher, generally above 50 kilodaltons. Compounds of this size have negligible membrane permeability. Let's now see the consequences of these properties on the PK behavior of these types of drugs. If a small molecule drug has good membrane permeability, then it may be administered orally. The drugs can cross the lining of the GI tract and ultimately reach the systemic circulation. Biologics have poor membrane permeability and are not absorbed orally. They are generally administered by injection, perhaps directly into the bloodstream, by IV, but more often by intramuscular or subcutaneous injection. In terms of clearance, for small molecule drugs, their permeability allows them to enter hepatocytes, where high concentrations of metabolic enzymes are found. The low molecular weight allows the compounds to fit into the active site of different metabolic enzymes. Clearance varies, but the main mode of clearance for small molecule oral drugs is in the liver, hepatic clearance. Biologics, with their large size and low permeability, cannot enter hepatocytes and therefore do not undergo hepatic clearance. Interestingly, biologics are normally too large to be filtered by the kidneys, so renal clearance of the unchanged drug is also negligible. The total clearance of biologics is very low. The volume of distribution of small molecule drugs varies considerably. Depending on the structure of the drug, volume of distribution may be relatively high or relatively low. Biologics, however, because of their poor permeability, are typically confined to the general circulation and the interstitial fluid that bathes the cells. Therefore, biologics tend to have quite low volume of distribution. Let's now look at half-life. The formula for half-life is in the upper left. Half-life is determined from a molecule's volume of distribution and clearance. For small molecule drugs, both clearance and volume of distribution can vary. So the half-life of small molecule drugs also varies. Half-life can range widely from an hour or even less and even up to days. A once-daily dose drug would typically have a half-life of 4 to 16 hours. But exceptions abound. In contrast, biologics, although their volume of distribution is low, these have an extremely small clearance. Therefore, half-life tends to be quite long and normally measured in days or even weeks. As a result, biologics can often be dosed on a weekly or even monthly basis. The less frequent dosing can offset some of the inconvenience of delivery by injection. We have now contrasted the ADME and PK properties of small molecule drugs with biologics and explained how these differences affect drug administration. Small molecule drugs and biologics are structurally very different, and that leads to very different pharmacokinetic properties. As always, thank you for watching to the end. Take care.